It's the Weather Xtreme video. This is the afternoon edition. This is for Thursday, the 7th of October. I'm James Spann. Alabama's weather looking dry for a while. Temperatures will likely stay above average through next week. Here we go. This is the upper air look. The upper low that's brought the unsettled wet weather to the state this week is now located near St. Louis, weakening and lifting out. Down below that, the sky partially sunny across much of the state this afternoon and really not much rain. That was the radar composite at 2:30. Had a couple of showers south of Birmingham, rain falling across parts of the Florida Panhandle in southeast Alabama, and that's about it. Still, technically, there's a flash flood watch for parts of east Alabama, but for all practical purposes, the risk of flooding has ended for the state for a while. And around the nation, a very quiet afternoon. Got a marginal risk of severe storms over the southwest corner of Georgia this evening, also parts of the Intermountain West. Tomorrow, a marginal risk, again, around Jacksonville, Florida, parts of South Georgia, North Florida. Also a marginal risk up north, the Dakotas and parts of Minnesota. Pretty much the same area up north on day three, which is Saturday. Here's the rain for the next 7 days. Big numbers out across the high plains, and for us, not much. Again, the green you see there in southeast Alabama, that's for the ongoing activity this evening. Most of the state will be dry tomorrow through at least the middle part of next week. And in the tropics, nice and quiet. We are watching that little disturbance that's off the coast of South Carolina. Just a low chance of that acquiring some subtropical characteristics as it drifts gradually to the northeast. But again, no issues for much of the Atlantic basin. So model fans, here we go, the GFS. This is the 12Z run, valid tomorrow at 4. 591 upper high over Texas, big trough in the western states, and here a northwest flow aloft. And a dry air mass, the sky partly to mostly sunny, highs between 81 and 84. For the weekend, warm and dry. This is Saturday and this is Sunday. Lots of sunshine both days. Highs in the mid-80s. Monday, we're still dry. We're still warm. Cold front to the west. That front will basically fizzle out before reaching us. This is Tuesday. We're still dry. Got a deep surface low that's near Goodland, Kansas. That'll provide a big snowstorm for parts of Colorado, Wyoming, and South Dakota. In advance of that, maybe some severe storms south and east of the surface low. But again, we're dry. Wednesday, we're still dry, the front to the west. And a week from today, Thursday the 14th, got an upper ridge nearby, and the front tries to push in here, and that might squeeze out an isolated shower maybe Thursday afternoon of next week. But with the ridge holding, why, significant rain really not expected. We'll go out 10 days. This is Sunday the 17th of October. Upper high over the southwest United States, a northwest flow aloft here. And again, that looks pretty quiet. Maybe a couple of showers over southeast Alabama, but a cold front is coming in. That could bring some noticeably cooler air in about 10 days. Rain for Birmingham off the GFS ensemble, not much. That looks like October. The mean is only about a half inch between now and the 23rd of October. Highs in the 80s, lows in the 60s through next week. But notice the spike down in about 10 days, around Sunday the 17th. Again, that's a sign of a pretty good pop of cool air at that point. But the latest CPC outlook here, this is for the 15th through the 21st, still showing temperatures at or just above average for the Deep South. That's it for the Weather Xtreme video this afternoon. We'll have notes on the blog, the next video here by 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. If you can, catch us this evening on ABC 3340 News at 4, 5, 6, and 10 o'clock. Thanks for watching. Have a great evening and God bless. Hey, this is James Spann. I think one of the best parts of my job, getting to do weather programs in schools. During regular times, I'm in a school once or twice a day, teaching students, mostly in elementary schools, things about weather and science. It's a really great part of my job. In fact, if I wasn't a television meteorologist, I would be a third grade science teacher. But one thing I've noticed over the years, some children, not all, but some, develop a genuine fear, a phobia of weather, especially thunderstorms and tornadoes. To offset that, I commissioned a couple of creative members of my family to write a series of children's books about weather. And the first one is out. Benny and Chipper, Be Prepared, Not Scared. Your kids will absolutely love Benny the Bear and his best pal, Chipper the Beagle Dog. It's a really good read about thunderstorms and tornadoes and how it's okay to be a little afraid, but you don't have to be really afraid. As long as you're prepared, you understand them, you know what to do, and you take care of yourself. Information is very powerful, and that starts a process of kids overcoming that fear. And this book is a really good read for any elementary school student. My friend Ginger Z of ABC News in New York, the chief meteorologist there, wrote a foreword here. Jeremy Davis, an illustrator, really makes Benny and Chipper come to life. It's a great read, and your kids will love it. I would encourage you to get a copy, and we'll have future books with Benny and Chipper about things like thunderstorms and the science behind them, tornadoes, and hurricanes. So get your copy today. Right now it's available online at spannbook.com. And you'll see some other cool stuff there as well. Benny and Chipper, Prepared, Not Scared. Get your kids a copy today.